General manager Chris Greer and the rest of the Miami Dolphins decision-makers have done a lot to improve their roster after the team missed the postseason for the fifth year in a row. They've added a number of players in free agency who will have varying levels of contributions, including Teron Armstead, Connor Williams, Raheem Mostert, Chase Edmonds, Alec Ingold, Cedric Wilson Jr., and Keon Crossan. They also took a swing in the trade market, sending 5 picks to the Kansas City Chiefs for wide receiver Tyreek Hill. With that trade leaving Miami with the fewest picks in this year's draft and some players whose roles could shrink in 2022, the Dolphins have been approached by a number of teams regarding trades. According to Greer at the owners' meetings on Monday, they've received calls on wide receiver Devontae Parker and center Michael Dieter. As NFL Network's Cameron Wolf mentions in his tweet, the wide receiver room is getting a bit more crowded with Hill and Wilson's arrivals. If everything goes right, Parker is the third or fourth option in the receiver room alone. And, while his contract isn't outrageous, it's a bit high for a guy who could be a team's fifth or sixth pass catcher. Dieter's name being mentioned is a little surprising. He's been decent in the middle of the line when he's been healthy, but he dealt with multiple injuries last year that cost him a significant amount of time. If the Dolphins are going to look to upgrade in the draft, and there's a strong possibility that they do so, they might consider those proposals. The Miami Dolphins got Tua Tagovailoa everything he needs to break out in 2022, led by superstars Tyreek Hill and Teron Armstead. It's been an up-and-down NFL career so far, for one of the most prolific passers in college football history. Every good moment endured by Tagovailoa during his time in Miami can easily be replaced by two bad ones. Who remembers the Arizona Cardinals game? Still till this day may be Tua's best NFL performance. We saw special in the State Farm Stadium that day, or what many referred to as Alabama Tua. How about the Buffalo Bills game in 2020, when the Dolphins were in a win and in situation for the playoffs, and the Bills rested their starters in the second half? Tua had debatably his worst NFL game of his career through 21 starts, throwing for 3 interceptions in a must-win game. Or how about the Tennessee Titans game this past year? Another must-win situation for Tagovailoa and the Dolphins, and the second-year quarterback completed 48% of his passes for a dreadful 53.1 rating. You see, Tagovailoa will need to add more great moments and limit the bad ones in 2022. Lack of support. As many Dolphins fans argue angrily on social media, Tua has had one of the worst situations any young quarterback could be thrown into since entering the league. No running game, bottom-tier weapons, a historically bad offensive line, some of the worst offensive coaches in the NFL, and the non-stop Deshaun Watson rumors. Now while all of this is true, it would be unfair to state Tua has been spectacular in spite of this. Despite not living up to his draft day hype thus far, general manager Chris Greer and owner Stephen Ross have not given up on the young player. To get the best out of their number 5 pick, the Dolphins front office put together an extensive head coach search, looking for someone to unlock the keys to a high-powered offense. Can Mike McDaniel develop Tua? After many weeks of going through candidates, the Dolphins front office decided on the ex-49ers offensive coordinator, Mike McDaniel. The 39-year-old is a part of the Mike Shanahan coaching tree, which has amounted to be one of the best in the league. Kyle Shanahan, Sean McVay, Matt LaFleur, Arthur Smith, Kevin Stefanski, and Nathaniel Hackett are all coaches product of the Mike Shanahan tree. The Dolphins hope McDaniel is the next young offensive mind who can put one of the league's best offenses together, using the West Coast offense with Tagovailoa at the forefront. A breakout season is coming. With all of this added talent and coaching around Tua, he will have to perform this season. There's no more excuses, or waiting around for Tagovailoa to prove himself any longer. It's clear the Dolphins are in win-now mode, and if Tua can't get it done, they won't hesitate to move on in 2023. Despite this high-pressure season for Tua, I believe he is gonna answer the call and put together a very impressive year 3 season. We've seen glimpses of what the Alabama star can do in the NFL, Tagovailoa just needs to be more consistent to reach his full potential. Tua will prove to be what we saw at Alabama. Accuracy. Anticipation. Special. 2022 will be fun.